So I just got a scam IRS voicemail and threatening to arrest me if I don't call this random number back from Missouri. So let's listen to it, and then I'm going to actually call these idiots back and mess with them a little bit.
601-879-4174. I repeat, 601-879-4174. Now if we do not hear from you, we have to issue an arrest warrant under your name and get you arrested. So get back to me as soon as possible.
Oh my God.
Thank you.
Oh my God, I better call these people back. This sounds legitimate. All right, I'm going to try calling from a block number, and we'll go from there. And I'm going to do the accent too, kind of throw them off a little bit.
Thank you for calling Internal Revenue Service. How are you? How can I help you today?
Yeah, hi, it's the Internal Revenue Service?
Correct. You have reached the Crime and Investigation Department of the IRS. How can I help you today?
Hi, I got a phone call that said if I don't call it back, y'all going to issue an arrest warrant for me.
Okay, at what time received that kind of phone call from our side?
About an hour ago, sir.
And do you know what was the message put into that call?
It said to call back right away, otherwise the arrest warrant is going to be served and they're going to come arrest me.
Okay, let me tell you so that you have reached the Crime and Investigation Department of the IRS. May I know whom I'm speaking with, first of all, sir?
Yes, Mr. Baxton.
You have to tell me your first and last name and your zip code so that I can put in my system and get the file in my friend. And then you let you know why the IRS called you, okay?
Yes, sir. Mr. James Baxton, B-A-X-T-O-N.
Just wait a minute. James, how do you pronounce your last name?
Baxton. B like Bravo. A. X. Like a xylophone. T O N.
Baxton. Okay, what so is it called, Mr. Baxton?
98188.
Okay, James Baxton. Okay. Just be on the hold, Mr. Baxton. Let me check why the IRS called you and let you know. Just be on the hold, sir.
Okay, thank you.
While we are trying to reach you is to inform you that there is an arrest warrant issued for tax evasion under your name, and your name is under the federal investigation. Should you receive any kind of phone call from your local sheriff's department or your local police department?
Have I gotten any phone calls from them?
Right. Do you receive any kind of phone call?
I don't want any trouble.
Are you trying to say that you are not aware about the situation happening under your name?
Okay, well that's good news. You're telling me there's no problem with my name?
I'm not saying that, Mr. Baxton. There is an arrest warrant issued against your name. Are you trying to say that you are not aware about the situation happening under your name? You are not aware about this?
I was unaware of any problems. I've been good on my taxes. And
yes, sir, I can see that you are paying your each and every year taxes regularly on time. But there are lots of errors and mistakes while you are filing them, and that is the reason you get this arrest warrant under your name, Mr. Baxton. First of all, grab a pen and a piece of paper and write it down some important information regarding this case. And after that, I'm going to explain the whole scenario, what is going wrong under your name, why the IRS called you, okay?
All right, I'm ready, sir. I have a pencil in my hand and a piece of paper.
Okay, first of all, write it down my name. Beside Officer Jeff Marshall.
Officer Marshall?
It's Officer Jeff Marshall, J.
Wrote it down.
Now write it down your arrest warrant ID number.
Okay?
It's 00-100-3636, like in 36 and 36.
Oh, all right. That's a lot of numbers. Man, a lot of arrest warrants going on, it looks like.
In between while I'm explaining the whole scenario to you, okay?
All right, I'm all ears. Go ahead.
Okay. And so it is also my job to make you aware that this is a three-way conference line with the Department of Homeland Security. So whatever you say or commit must be 100% truth and honest, because this phone recording will be serving in the front of the Bar Council of the State to prove you innocent or guilty. Now, let me ask you a question. So can you just help me out with the number on which you get the phone call?
$1,130.
It's not. It's $6,133.
And how many cents are we talking here?
$6,133.26.
All right. So I want to be good for every cent there, sir.
So right now, Mr. Baxton, let me tell you that you have found suspicious and breaching three important laws of the United States. Count one, violation of Internal Revenue Code. Count two, violation of federal tax rules and regulations, and count three, providing misleading information to the government authorities.
All right.
Now, Mr. Baxter, I have a few legal questions which I need to get an answer from you in a simple yes or no, okay?
I'm ready. Fire away.
Are there, Mr. Baxter? Hello?
Yeah, I'm out here.
So, question number one is, have you ever been arrested before by the state police or by the sheriff's department?
Well, by golly, I don't recall. I don't reckon I have.
No, just wanted your simple yes or no. Have you ever been arrested before?
No.
Have you ever filed a bankruptcy or foreclosure in the past?
No.
Are there any kind of legal judgment under your name which is still pending apart from this tax evasion case?
No.
Okay, I believe that you have answered all my questions with your almost honesty. Now, proceeding further is to provide you with limited information over the phone, which I believe I have already done. Now, Mr. Baxton, you have only two options left, and they are: either you can resolve or rectify this matter outside the court hall without facing any kind of legal consequences, or else you can fight a case against the IRS in the court house, where if you fail to prove you're innocent inside the court house, then the government will sue you with more than $30,000 to $35,000, and also they will going to send you to Alaska for 3 years federal imprisonment, which have been settled in Alaska. And after the hang-ups call, within 40 to 45 minutes, you will be get arrested by your local sheriff's department for within custody of 3 days, and they will be going to seize all your property assets. All your bank accounts will be frozen. Also, your SSN number will be get blocked.
Oh, by God. I can't afford to do that.
How would you like me to take right now, you have to tell me, how would you like me to take this case or rectify this matter outside the courthouse?
Outside the courthouse, by the flagpole, wherever you want to do, outside the courthouse. I have a question, sir.
What was your question, Mr. Baxter?
Well, are you a federal employee?
Yes, sir, you have reached.
Well, why are you still working? The government been shut down for 32 days.
No, so you got the wrong information. We have done a random audit on your past tax files right now.
Oh, you got so the federal
you owe, which have been settled for our audit department, and then they got this. You are not able to get relief.
Oh, that's great that the IRS is still working despite the government shutdown.
You got the wrong information.
I don't... Okay, what do you want me to say?
Listen, do you want to do, listen, what is the case about? Do you want to know, right?
Yeah, do you need my credit card info?
Do you want to resolve this matter outside the courthouse or not?
Yes, sir, I do.
I'm just going to transfer a call to my heart. I talked to you. Just be on the hold, Mr. James.
Wow. So, what a scam. I lied to him about my first and last name. Made up a phone number, zip code, and he apparently found me. And I'm about to give him $6,000 to settle the matter outside the courthouse.
Thank you for holding the line. Your line has been transferred to me. This is the Senior Investigating Officer, Richard Weber. How are you doing today?
Oh, I've been better, you know, getting a phone call saying I owe some money, but I'm trying to make it right.
Mm-hmm. So, I believe you understand the case, what the case is all about.
I do. He said something about the government's been auditing, and they've found me.
Yeah, that's right.
All right.
That's right. Now, Mr. Baxton, your line has been transferred to me because you want to resolve the case outside the courthouse without facing any kind of legal consequences, without getting arrested.
That's right.
Right?
That's right, sir. Mm-hmm. Sir, if I didn't, you said the sheriffs would come to my house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
The sheriff's department here where I live?
Yes.
All right, well... Okay, I don't want that.
How do you want to resolve this case? Do you want to resolve this case publicly, or you want to resolve this case private and confidentially with the IRS?
On the down low. I want it on the down low.
Now, Mr. Baxton, where do you have this kind of money? Do you have it in a bank account? Where do you have it?
I have a credit card.
And what's the limit left in a credit card?
Oh, it's quite a bit. About 30 grand, I think.
And what about your bank account?
I got lots of... I'm a retired person, and all my retirement's tucked away in the savings account there.
So in the case, you have to have the cash with you because you have to follow a procedure which is called the Electronic Federal Tax Payment System.
Okay.
So what do you have to do? You have to go to your bank. You have to withdraw the cash of $6,133. Then after, I'm going to give you the location where you need to go to get the cash and to follow the procedure, okay?
All right, sir. I'm all ears.
How far is a bank from your present location, from your current location?
It's about a quick stroll, about 5 minutes stroll down the block. I can just walk.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now, once you reach the bank, once you reach the parking lot of the bank, once you stand outside the bank, just let me know, okay?
So I have to stay on the phone with you?
Yes, you have to stay on the phone with me all the time.
Okay. Well, by golly, sir, I have something to tell you. I'm a police officer.
Sorry, what?
I'm a police officer. I've been fucking with you for 20 minutes.
Keep on fucking for more.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Come to my house. Come to my house. Come find me. Man. You're funny, man. That was funny. Thank you for the good time. What a scam, you guys. I'm going to call...
Wait.
I'm a police officer, and I just recorded you on everything, so get ready for it, partner.
You're a police officer.
I am. Have fun.
You want my address?
Have fun.
You want my address?
Have fun.
You want my address?
Oh,
you're
funny. You're just mad because I messed with you.
Come down, you.
Free entertainment, buddy. Free entertainment, Officer Marshall or whoever you are.
It was, actually. It was.
Okay.
Funny.
Yeah, it was. All right. Take care.